Welcome back to my channel and another video here. Today I have a little bit of a bonus video for you. I got sent some gel polishes from the brand Nail Addict, and I didn't have anywhere in my normal calendar to stick it, my usual Tuesday, Saturday video, so I figured let's just throw it in on a Thursday, see what you guys think. So the brand, like I said, Nail Addict, they reached out to me and they asked me, do you want to try some of our products? And at first I was a little bit hesitant when I pulled up their website because everything is gel and I have never really used gel before. The only gels that I've used are, I got the Jelly Cure System from Zoya for free and I tried that out a couple times, which I liked it. And then a friend of mine gave me a couple gels which I used over a PLF base coat and they popped off immediately. So I've never really committed to gel in the past. So I was, like I said, hesitant, but I thought, you know what the heck, let me give it a try. Let me see how this fits into my lifestyle. You know, I have clearly a wealth of regular nail polishes behind me, and I will never get through all of them as is. And I thought, why would I prolong a manicure? But I think that this does have a good place in my life, and I will talk about that at the end, how I'm going to use these. But first, let me just give a shout out to the brand Nail Addict. They are a vegan, cruelty-free, nine-free gel polish, and they did share with me a code. It's going to be in the description box as well as their website if you want to go check them out. It'll be 50% off. The code, I believe, is Mediocre Manny's, just my channel name. That doesn't give me any kickback or anything. That's just for you guys to get a discount if you are interested. So they let me, like I said, pick out seven polishes, and I ended up trying to kind of get a diverse range of polishes in different finishes, because one thing I didn't realize before they reached out to me was gel polish has a ton of finishes, just like regular polish. I don't know why that didn't occur to me, but I guess really the only gel that I've seen around here when I see people get their nails done, they're all plain cream. So I just kind of assumed that's all gel is, you know? But as I browsed their website, I realized there's tons of different finishes. They carry lamps as well if you don't have a UV lamp. And they also have like base and top coats. I believe they even have a gel matte top coat, which again, not a thing I knew existed. But I ended up getting just a regular wipe top coat. I got a base coat and then I got five different polishes in four different finishes. So I will show each one of those to you guys. I'm going to do my regular live swatches that I do, but you have to cure it in between layers. So I'm not sure how that's gonna look. And then I will show you the swatch photos as well because I took full hand swatches of all five of those colors. And then we will come back and just kind of talk about the pricing and the quality and how this will fit into my life. So first we're gonna swatch the two creams that I got. The first one is called Lucky Bamboo. This is kind of a slimy, not quite neon green. And you're gonna see, this is the first time I've ever used these. So I didn't realize just how little you need on the brush compared to a regular nail polish. And so I kind of like put way too much on, but luckily with gel polishes, you have all the time in the world to manipulate it. You could scoop it back off, you can add more back on. And then this is after the first curing. It's very sheer on that first coat, but with the second coat, you can build it up. I found that was true of all but the last one, and the last one was pretty much a one coater for me, even with the little bit of nail line I have right now. And as you can see, I was just kind of having a hard time manipulating it. I'm still learning. If you have any tips for me, please let me know. But you can see I had this huge patch there and I was like, oh my gosh, what did I do? So I was able to just go back, get a little bit more on the brush and add it right in that section, which is really hard to do with regular polish. So I felt like that was a really cool feature of the gel polish. And here it is under my ring lights, just really bright, fun green. The second cream I picked out is called Malibu. And this is one of those like blurple colors, you know, that kind of in between a blue purple. I really like these kinds of colors, so I was instantly drawn to this one. However, I had quite a difficult time, not only here in my live swatch, but when I was taking swatch photos as well. Here you can see I kind of was pulling up my base coat with it, even though I waited
5 minutes. I don't know what was going on with that because I didn't have this problem with any of the other colors. I waited the exact same amount of time. And after that, though, after that first curing, I was able to apply the second coat without any problems. But I do feel like I left it a little bit lumpy. The brush was a little bit stiff and the polish was stickier and thicker than the other four that I got. So it might be user error. I'm not sure. But here is the swatch photo. I think the color is beautiful. I just got to figure it out. Next is a orange shimmer that I picked out. This one is called Jack-O-Lantern. You can really tell I picked these out around Halloween because I was going for the Halloween colors for the most part here. Now on that first coat, this one went on so much easier, and I don't know if it's just because I finally learned by this stage, but I really am so glad you can see that shimmer because when I first pulled the brush out, I was kind of concerned. I was like, is this going to be too subtle? Is this going to translate on the nail? But after that first curing, I went in and I added that second coat. You can still kind of see some visible nail line on this one, but part of that is just because the ring lights are quite bright. I do think that to the naked eye, just in your everyday life, people are not going to notice that. I didn't even see it until I got, you know, all the footage onto my computer screen. So I really don't think that more than two coats will be necessary. And here is the swatch photo. You can really see all that shimmer shining through. It looks really dainty. It looks really cute. I like that. Then we have our super chunky glitter. This one is called Forest Mural. Now I specifically picked a chunkier glitter because I just wanted to see how does chunky glitter translate on the nail with a gel? Because, you know, with regular nail polish, it dries down very textured. You have to put several coats of top coat on it, or you need to add the Glisten and Glow Glitter Grabber or something like that. And even still, there's a little bit of texture sometimes. So I just wanted to know what was going to happen with this one. And I was really pleasantly surprised because I found two things. It's so much easier to manipulate the chunkier glitters on this because you have eternity to do it. And once you put the top coat, the gel top coat over the top of this and cure it, you pretty much lose all that texture. It encapsulates it and the top is quite smooth. You don't have to worry about that. So it's a really nice feature of gel polishes to not have to worry about the texture. And I love this. It looks straight up like a Christmas tree. And then finally, we have Ocean's Heart. This is a finer hollow glitter, like very fine, super reflective hollow glitter. I really did not expect to like this one as much as I did. Like, look at that. Even it's a one coater for sure. I don't even care about that sort of a thing, but I was really, really surprised to see just how opaque this was on that first go around, and very smooth formula, even with that like thinner coat. And you can just see, it looks like crushed diamonds in there. The name Ocean's Heart is honestly the perfect name for this because it just reminds me of the ocean. It reminds me of a big old sapphire. You know, I think that this is the shocking favorite for me. And when you look at the swatch photo, you can just really see all that hollow coming through. I'm really excited for this one.
So, what did you guys think? Do any of you use gels? If so, please critique my form because I know that I'm still learning how to manipulate the gel and stuff like that on my nails. So, probably not the greatest application on my end, but I still really enjoyed them. I found them almost all easy to apply except for the purple one, Malibu. I don't know if you saw, I struggled a little bit and I struggled in the swatch photo application as well. There's something about the brush on this one, even though it's the same brush, I don't know if it's like the thickness of the gel compared to the other ones, but it made the brush really quite stiff and hard to manipulate, which is a shame because I really liked this color. However, I didn't find that I had that problem with any of the other colors, and I was especially impressed with this one, Ocean's Heart, just how glittery it was, how the tops, the caps, they have like the polish color itself kind of encapsulated in it, but this, it didn't prepare me for just how shimmery, glittery, hollow it was going to be. So this is one that if it's ever sunny again here in Michigan, I want to wear this when it's really sunny out and just see it under the natural sun because I think that this one is really pretty and surprisingly my favorite of the five. I really just assumed it was going to be the purple, because usually that's just how it goes for me. So as far as pricing goes for these, they are $19.95 a bottle, and these bottles are 15 milliliters or half an ounce, which is quite large compared to other gels that I've personally seen. Back when I was working at Ulta and I would like stock some of the nail polish, I remember there was a brand called Red Carpet and the bottles were really, really small. And I looked it up, they are 0.3 ounces, so like a little over a quarter of an ounce for about $10. And if you buy these, like I said, it's about 20 bucks for half an ounce, or you can use the code they gave me. It's in the description. It's Mediocre Manny's, and you get 50% off. So that should bring these down to about 10 bucks a bottle. So 10 bucks for half an ounce versus 10 bucks for 0.3 ounces. I think that's kind of a steal right there. And like I said, they have a really wide variety of colors, of finishes. I think it's worth it to just poke around, especially if you're interested in trying gels, because I found that as someone who was really hesitant, really nervous, just kind of like, I don't think I can do this about gels, I found that these were really easy to go through, use, and they all looked really nice. And like I said, with the exception of Malibu, I didn't have any issues at all. And I kind of wonder if maybe it was just an application error on my end, or maybe the bottle is just extra thick. I guess I don't know enough about gels yet to really tell you that. But like I said, all the other four worked like a charm. So why gels? You know, as somebody who changes their manicure every 2 to 3 days, why would I want to deal with the hassle of gels? Well, I have a couple reasons for you. The first being nail art. Just the manipulation of this is so much easier than regular polish. You have all the time in the world to play around with it before you cure it, which if you mess up, it's really easy to wipe it off and start all over again. And that's something that I, as the worst nail artist in the world, really need. I just need a lot of time so that I can really like finesse the brush and everything. So I think that these would be really ideal for nail art. And I kind of understand why a lot of the really big Instagram nail artists use gel polishes, because it just gives you a lot more time to work. The biggest reason I kind of wanted some gels was for vacations. You know, I used to, whenever we went on vacations, I would bring a whole little kit of just a couple polishes, some small bottle of acetone, you know, base and top coat, because I was gonna change my nails on vacation. But lately, I don't really get vacations. I don't get to take vacations. My boyfriend works like 85 hours a week right now. I only work 40, but where am I gonna go by myself, you know? And so when we eventually do get to go on a vacation, I really don't want to waste it by painting my nails in a hotel room. Like, I don't have time for that right now. So having a gel that's really not going to budge, that's going to stay put for several days, maybe a week or more. I think gels last quite a long time. It's going to be ideal because I don't have to worry about my nails. It's going to, like, because I don't want to go bare nailed on vacation. I know I'm bare-nailed now, but that's because I was doing swatches earlier. It's too dangerous. You know, you don't want to risk it. So I want to have something on my nails. And if I have something that I know is not going to budge, it's not going to scuff up, it's not going to look too bad after a week or so, then that's kind of the ideal. And so I think that these are going to be perfect for a vacation. I just kind of am kicking myself because I probably should have gotten a few more, I don't know, like safe or neutral colors, because some of these are pretty obnoxious, so I don't know. I probably will go back and pick up a few more of these in like maybe a neutral for my skin tone and maybe like a nice red or something like that. Just because I really do think that these are going to be the answer to that question for me of what am I going to wear on vacation, you know? I think that's a really great way to solve that problem. And so the third way that I feel like I could really utilize gels in my life is on other people. I do have people every now and again saying, oh, you should paint my nails, or, oh, can you paint my nails, kind of a thing. And I'm like, yeah, I can. But then they find out that I don't use gels. And they're like, oh, I only use gel. And, you know, for me, I change my nails so frequently that I don't care. But they're like people that they like to put on nail polish as like the wearing it is kind of like the self-care, like the enjoyment is that their nails look pretty, that somebody else did their nails. And for me, the enjoyment of nail polish is doing my own nails. You know, I like to paint it on. I like to change the colors frequently. I like to get finicky with it and change it up. But a lot of other people don't. Like, they just don't have time for that. It's not their, like, top priority like it is mine. And so I think it would be nice to have, like, a small set of, like, basic essential gel colors so that I could do other people's nails. Like, so, like, my grandma told me she recently only wears gels now. And she only wears pink gels, so I gotta get a pink gel for her. And I know that, I think my mom really only wears gels, and she seems to only wear red gels, so gotta get red, because I didn't get pink or red like a dork over here. So that's one thing, that's another category that I feel like I could really use these. And then I put four reasons down, but my fourth reason is really lame. It's just, these are so glossy, like, gel polish, gel finish looks so much shinier than regular top coat just over the course of its entire life. I feel like gel top coat just really maintains that shine in a way that a regular top coat typically can't. And I see why so many brands put out, you know, the gel-like finish, the gel-like top coats, and like, they confuse everybody because they're like, is it gel? Is it not? But no, they're just supposed to mimic that shininess. But even after a couple days, those get dull and they're not as, like, thick and, like, squishy looking as the gel top coats are. And so I can understand why people prefer this finish, because it really does look like boom, glossy, shiny, well manicured. It just looks really pulled together. And so I think that I kind of understand now why people have such an affinity for gel, because it really does look really pretty. So all that said, while gel is not going to be an everyday thing for me, I do think that it has a good place in my life, specifically when I just don't have time to be doing my nails every 3 days. It'll be nice to have these around. I also think it would be kind of cool to make my own, like, press-ons and stuff like that. I've seen other people do it, not to sell, just for myself, because I'm not, like, good at nail art. I'm not that creative, but I know that a lot of people use gel for those as well. I think I saw Cork Manicures was doing that recently, making press-ons, and I think she was using gel. And then I have a friend who, she is trying to start making press-ons, and I'm pretty sure she uses gel for everything. So there's just one more reason that, you know, you could use these. So yeah, that's gonna be it from me on this one. Let me know down below if you've tried Nail Addict or if you've heard of this brand before. I am only, like I said, just learning about gels, so this is only, like, the third gel brand that I've ever heard of. Let me know if you've tried them, what your thoughts are, and if you're going to go check out their website, let me know what some of your favorite colors are on there, because I think I'm going to probably pick up a few more of these in the next couple of weeks, just so that I have, like I said, like a staple red and like a staple nude for my skin and things like that. But anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed this bonus video, and I will see you in the next one. Bye. Okay, secret bonus content for all the real ones who stick around all the way to the end of my videos. Yeah, I've been wearing this sweatshirt for like 4 days. Don't at me about that, but look. Oh, I know, I flipped them the wrong way. Look. My boyfriend bought me this for our 8-year anniversary, which is on Friday. So anyways, that's all I wanted to say. Goodbye.